Hello everyone, it's Old Guardian here. In this video I'm going to show you the world record kill of the buffed Baron Geddon with armies with combined average level of 22.5. Yeah, 22.5, I'm not kidding, although you need a couple of key minis at slightly higher level. These are the armies that I use with Turtle for the world record kill. The overall strategy is exactly the same as I showed in my Geddon guide. You take the towers, you wait until close to overtime, then you push the phases in rapid succession. Push phase 1, there's a wipe, you defend the towers, you push phase 2 really quickly, the towers are still safe, and then there's a wipe near Geddon as well again here, and then you push phase 3, and that is going to be game. So the armies themselves. We were both playing with Rend, although Rend is not mandatory, you could do this with other leaders as well. But the minis are more important. So both armies have Whelpecs, both armies have Darkhire Miners, and both armies have Chimeras. I also have Fairy Dragon, Gargoyle, and Cheetah, whereas Turtle has Harpies, Banshee, and Quillbore. And what do all of these do? Chimera is really the key unit. Chimera is one of the best units for pushing dragon towers, and you really want to take those dragon towers down. So 27 Chimera boosted for Turtle, that's excellent. 24 Chimera will start to struggle. 23 was too difficult. I don't like doing this with 23 at all. 24, I don't really like that. I would love to have the 25, even 26 would both be better. 24 can do it. Sometimes getting a resistance on that with Fairy Dragon can help, and that can take some of the towers. And once you take towers, you want to keep those towers. So we have Whelpecs. Whelpecs can reclaim towers really quickly. Darkhire Miners can help reclaim towers. They can also mine. And Turtle has the poison talent on Quillbore. Tunnel Vision would be the second best. Quillbore can also come in and start hitting the tower before Geddon manages to rebuild it, so that we can keep it out of Geddon's reach. There's Banshee for taking some Gargoyles, Fire Elementals, that get through. There's Harpies defending against Gargoyles, defending against Fire Elementals. Then there's that Cheat Death, because originally I was running Polymorph, but on this account my Polymorph in a golden slot was level 20, and the duration was just too short. It needs to be something like 22, 23. I did this last time to level 24 Polymorph, which was already so much better. But because I didn't have those, I have Cheat Death. And Cheat Death, when you use Cheat Death on a Chimera that's engaged in combat, that's an instant full heal. Because Chimera has put in some poison stacks, and those poison stacks with the lifesteal effect from the talent just heal the Chimera full instantly. And that can really help out winning some fights. And then there's that Gargoyle, the crucial Gargoyle, that is going to deal the majority of damage to Geddon. You make it resistant with Fairy Dragon. If the Gargoyle is high enough, it doesn't need that. But this 26 Gargoyle resistance on that is still quite important. We tried to do this with Gargoyle not in a boost, so 22 Gargoyle, but we could not finish phase 3. Obviously, getting to phase 3 when we had Chimeras in the boost slot, so a pair of 27 Chimeras, super easy to get to phase 3, but super hard to finish Geddon. So we had to make it a little bit more difficult to get to phase 3 by making my Chimera a little bit lower level. 24 was still doable. And then get a little bit more levels on that Gargoyle so that it can deal enough damage to Geddon. And this is what the world record kill looks like in action. Alright, here we go. I'm going to try to talk you through this fight. So at the very start of the fight, I want to send my Chimera to the left. I'm making the Chimera resistant because the 24 Chimera can't really handle the tower without being resistant. So I have to make it resistant, but I also don't want to send the Fairy Dragon there, because we want to send the main push up, so that it will face the main of Geddon's armies. Geddon is not going to do much about a single Chimera, but if I send Chimera together with the Fairy Dragon, it gets more opposition there. Now, one resistant Chimera has a chance to succeed. Sometimes you need to reinforce that push, but sometimes it just goes over there and you do other things. So here, for example, we have another Chimera, non-resistant but higher level, engaging the other tower, and then Whelpecs were dropped behind the tower so that then they could loot the tower in the back. And that's how we managed to get the top left and the top right towers. That's step number one, because we want all the towers. Next up, we want to start moving towards the bottom right tower, and then we want to move after Geddon. And whenever Geddon takes a tower, we want to force it so that it will not be rebuilt with Whelpecs, with Quillbores, and then just Geddon will be completely out of towers and completely out of playing minis. But first we have to get there. And in order to get there, we need to get some attacks going. And as you can see, we're playing minis a bit all over the place now that we have time. Because we don't want to create a single big death ball at this stage, because that's just going to invite living bombs. We want there to be minis and repeated attacks and assaults until we get to our goal, which is taking those towers. So here we go, we're attacking the bottom right tower, this time with a resistant gargoyle. The resistant gargoyle is just going to whack at that tower, and again, see Welbeck behind, and here we go. Now Geddon manages to take the top left tower, but we have Turtle on the job, so Turtle is going to be ready with the quill bore, and the tower is not going to be rebuilt, because Geddon is already on its way elsewhere, while the quill bore is sneakily chipping away at the tower. The top right, bottom left towers, you can do this with Welbeck's. The others, you need to use Quillbore, or you can also use Dark Eye Miner in a pinch. And you can see my cheat death gameplay here. Getting cheated on the Chimeras, getting them instantly healed to full, and then just able to take the towers. And now we have reached a position where we have all the towers. Geddon does not own a single tower. Geddon cannot play any minis. It's only fire elementals for now, as long as we can keep the towers from being rebuilt. This tower is a little bit tricky because Geddon sometimes is a little bit slow there, and that means that now we needed to use two pairs of Whelp eggs so that we can keep the tower from being rebuilt. And well, from here, it's mostly a waiting game. We're going to keep playing stuff. We want to spread that stuff around, and we wouldn't want to really engage Geddon. That would be quite important. I think actually in this kill we engage Geddon a little bit too early in the end. But we just want to keep playing stuff around. We don't necessarily want them to be one big death ball. They are already starting to clump up a little, and that is not great. We don't want them to engage Geddon, but we are perfectly safe from living bombs at the moment, because living bomb has been spent after all the towers were lost, and Geddon cannot cycle minis, so Geddon cannot get access to living bomb until Geddon gets a tower built. So until Geddon gets a tower built, we are perfectly safe here. Now our death ball is starting to... That is terrible positioning of the Chimera for me. Sorry about that. Yeah, I really should not have put it there to fight against Geddon. I should have put it up top so that it would just fly a long way behind Geddon. Anyway, Geddon taking some towers. We're of course mining gold. We're playing some minis around, and we're trying to prevent any towers from getting rebuilt. As you can see, the loyal Quillbore is chipping away at the tower's health, so the tower does not get rebuilt, and as long as the tower is not rebuilt, Geddon cannot play minis. Okay, Geddon now progressing, and the death ball is reaching. Geddon, go, run away. Yes, the fire elemental is delaying the death ball just enough so that Geddon gets away. Phew, that's good. Because ideally we want to engage Geddon very close to the start of overtime, so that we will have more gold. Because then Geddon is going to wipe all the minis that are very close to Geddon at each phase change. So then we get a phase change, we have to rebuild, and phase change, and we have to rebuild. And those resistant gargoyles, we need to try to send multiple resistant gargoyles at Geddon. Typically the first phase, I mean, the dragon towers are always dealing some damage, so typically we need two resistant gargoyles. One would be needed. Well, now the first phase change, one would be needed, now one a little bit later. We can defend all the towers, so we're defending this, we're preventing the bottom left from being rebuilt, and we're defending all the others so that those fire elementals, they fall to one Chimera, one set of whale packs, pretty much anything in addition to the tower, and they will fall. And now I'm starting to send a resistant gargoyle here. This is not my favorite place to fight against Geddon. Ideally I would like to face Geddon at the top, and then I would just send minis to the top from our base. That would be what I would really want if I could arrange everything perfectly, because here we're going to have some problems with the swirls. As you can see, the gargoyle, it's resistant, and resistant it was actually, it wasn't quite enough. No, we would really need to get a phase on this Geddon as soon as we can get a phase. And this is a bit of a mistake here. I'm sending the gargoyle, but I didn't realize that there's actually the swirl is coming. So what I needed to do is I needed to wait for Geddon to move a little bit further, and only then send more minis out there. Geddon has now managed to get a tower. Living bomb becomes a danger, but hey, what are you going to living bomb? We don't have that many minis anywhere. Now Geddon is marching towards the left, and we're trying to ambush it there, but it's also a little bit poor because the swirl is coming from up top, and that's going to be painful. So you can see here we have a gargoyle going in. The gargoyle is going in at the same time as the swirl is coming in, and the swirl is sticking and Geddon is sticking. So gargoyle just does not deal enough damage. So we're going to need a little bit more. Turtle is now defending, and I'm unable to cycle to another gargoyle. The swirl went by, and now we have another gargoyle. Geddon is slow enough, and that's going to be it. That's going to be a win, and that is the world record kill on Baron Geddon. Thank you for watching. Click like and subscribe if you enjoyed this, and a special thanks to all of my Patreon supporters, YouTube members, and Twitch subscribers who make all of these videos possible.